Hi friends, welcome to this channel. Once again, I request you to share, comment, and subscribe the channel. We were doing, in the previous clip, we were discussing about power transmission. I started the belt drive and I told you that the mathematical treatment, we saw what are the things to be found. We found velocity ratio, formula for velocity ratio, for finding length of belt, width of belt, tension ratio, and the power. What is the power transmitted? In this above discussion, in the discussion we have had already, we have not considered one thing into we have not considered one particular thing, that is what we call centrifugal tension. Centrifugal tension, we have not taken this into consideration. You know, this is denoted by TC. You know, the belt keeps rotating around these pulleys, around the pulleys. You know, even something at having mass is rotated in a circular orbit or elliptical orbit, it is subjected to a natural force called as the centrifugal force. That centrifugal force, we call it as centrifugal tension here. Right, this we have not taken into consideration. Now, at lower speeds, this centrifugal tension is smaller and it can be neglected. We can say we don't take it into consideration. But when the speed is high, it will be sufficiently large and this has to be taken into consideration. Now, what happens when it is taken into consideration? When it is taken into consideration, two relationships change. That is, one is tension ratio. This tension ratio, you know, we was T1 by T2. Now it becomes, if you take it into consideration, it will be T1 minus TC divided by T2 minus TC is equal to e to the power of mu theta. This will be the tension ratio. Then power transmitted, P will be equal to T1 minus TC into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu theta into V divided by 1000. So many kilowatts it becomes. So these two formulae, the other will not change. That is, velocity ratio equation will not change. The ratio of the relationship for width will not change, length will not change. These two relationships will be changed like this. This will be the relationship if TC is considered. Now, how to find TC? Now, TC, that is centrifugal tension, this will be equal to mv square. This is the formula for tension. So, centrifugal tension, so many newtons. Now, here, V stands for velocity of belt. Already we know how to find it. Velocity of belt will be equal to pi d n by 60. You can take any one pulley, take the diameter of the same pulley and RPM of the same pulley, and you will get it. This you will get in meters per second. So many meters per second. Right. Now, this M, what is M? Mass of belt. mass of belt in kg per meter length. Now, this mass of belt M may be given directly in a problem. It will be sometimes given directly, or instead of giving mass, they will give you the density of belt. Density of belt will be given in rho, in kg per cubic meter. It will be given in kg per cubic meter, rho, density. So if it is given as density is given, then rho into b into t, that is area of the belt, will give you the this thing in kg per meter. Here rho is density of belt material. Rho is density. Rho is density of belt material. N kg per cubic meter. B is width of belt in meter, and T is thickness of belt in meter. So if these three are known, then we can get. So whenever they give this mass in a problem on belt drive, if mass is given or density of the belt material is given, that means we have to take centrifugal tension into consideration. If neither this nor this is given in the problem, it indicates that the problem we need not consider the centrifugal tension into, we need not take it into consideration. Then we have to, this is how it is to be done. Now so far we have seen the numericals, what can be asked in the flat belt drive. These, all these formula that we discussed now are in on flat belt drive, for flat belt drive. Now they can ask a problem on V belt drive also. V belt drive also we can get a problem in case it is asked. It can be asked, a problem can be asked on V belt drive, or it can be on rope drive also. Rope drive, they can ask a problem, a simple problem on V belt as well as rope drive. If it is asked on V belt, the difference is this V belt is running on grooved pulleys. So the pulley will have a groove in which the belt will sit like this. This is how the belt will sit. This is the groove in which the belt will sit. This is the belt. So it is trapezoidal, this groove. Now here what will come is, this is extra. This angle is called as alpha. That alpha is called groove angle. Groove angle in degrees. In degrees. This will come both in rope drive as well as belt drive, V belt drive. In V belt drive, normally what will be asked, or even in rope drive, what is asked is number of belts, because you can use multiple belts in when the power is large, when we have to transmit very large power, we use multiple belt drive in V belt drive. So number of belts. If it is rope drive, they will ask number of ropes, or if number of ropes is given, they will ask power. If power is given, power to be transmitted is given, then they will ask us to find out the number of belts or number of ropes. This is extra. Now here you will not get problems in this, either on velocity ratio you will not get a problem, length you will not get a problem, you will not get a problem on thickness, finding thickness also. Only two formula you have to know. One is the formula for tension ratio, and the other one is the formula for power. Two formula, both in V belt as well as this thing. Now number of belts or number of ropes, it will be groove angle will be same. Now if TC, what is TC? Centrifugal tension is not considered, is neglected, we don't take it into consideration, then tension ratio will be T1 by T2 is equal to e to the power of mu theta by sine of alpha by 2, half cone angle, that groove angle it is called, not cone angle, it is called groove angle. It will be in degrees, but theta will be in radians. Theta is the angle of contact between belt and pulley, that will be in radians, and alpha should be in degrees. And this is the tension ratio. P will be equal to T1 by minus T2 into V, N into T1 minus T2 by V divided by 1000. This N will be extra, that is number. So if P is given, they normally ask N. If N is given, they normally ask what is the power that can be transmitted. Next. Next. In rope drive also same formula. If TC is considered, is not neglected, is considered, then tension ratio will be T1 minus TC divided by T2 minus TC is equal to e to the power of mu theta by sine of alpha by 2, and P will be equal to N into T1 minus TC into 1 minus 1 by e to the power of mu theta by sine of alpha by 2, whole thing, this whole thing multiplied by V divided by 1000. This is the formula. Next, one more thing in this is, one more thing we should remember is, what is the condition for maximum power transmission? That is, when the power transmitted will be maximum. We can show mathematically in belt drive or rope drive, the power transmission condition for maximum power transmission under what condition maximum power is transmitted. See here, the condition is in all this, in rope drive, belt drive, everything, what we have to do is, the maximum power is transmitted when TC, that is centrifugal tension, is one third of maximum tension, or tension on tight side. It is one third of tension on tight side. When this condition is satisfied, we will transmit maximum power. There is a proof for this, but we don't require it, that will not be asked. It is enough if you know it, or it can also be written like this, T1 is equal to 3TC. This way also it can be written. Anyway, both are same. If 3 is sent this side, it will become T1 is equal to 3TC. T1 is tension on tight side, TC is the centrifugal tension. So this is the condition for maximum power transmission in a belt or rope drive or V belt drive, flat belt drive, for all these drives. That is the condition for maximum power. The centrifugal tension should be one third of the tension on tight side. So this you must remember. So on these you will get numericals. We will take up numericals now. I have selected a few numericals from this thing. The first question, first problem from the question bank is this. It is, an engine running at 150 rpm drives a line shaft by means of a belt. The engine pulley is 750 mm dia, and the pulley on the line shaft being 450 mm. Full stop. A 900 mm dia pulley on the line shaft drives a 150 mm dia pulley keyed to a dynamo shaft. Calculate the speed of the dynamo shaft when there is no slip, when there is a slip of 2% on each pulley. So this is the problem. See here, this first problem, you have a engine shaft. This is the engine shaft. engine shaft. No. This is the engine shaft. On this shaft, you have a pulley. You have a pulley of it is running at 150 rpm. This pulley runs at 150 rpm, and it transmits power by means of a belt to another pulley, which is on the line shaft. This is the line shaft. Now this pulley, this is one, this is two, then there is one more pulley here. The engine pulley is 750 mm dia. This is RPM is 150 and dia is 750. Now on the same shaft, there is this is the diameter of this pulley, is the line shaft being 450 mm. This is 450 mm. Here you have another pulley of 900 mm dia. 900 mm dia. This is pulley number 3. Now this drives, this gives power to the dynamo shaft. This is the dynamo shaft. This we'll call it as 4. 4. It is calculate the speed of the dynamo shaft when there is no slip. 150 mm dia. This is 150 mm. So the pulley 1 drives pulley 2. Now because these two are both on the same shaft, they will be running at the same speed, and this will drive that. Now first what we have to do is we have to find what is the speed of this. So if we neglect slip, if there is no slip, neglecting slip and also thickness, thickness is not given, belt thickness is not given, we know that N1D1 is equal to N2D2. So I have to find out N2 here. N2 is to be found out. I don't know it. I know N1, D1 and D2. I know these things. So N2 will be equal to N1D1 divided by D2. N1D1 divided by D2 will be equal to N2. So now N1 is 750 into D1 is 150 divided by D2 is 450. 450, simple, it will be 250 rpm. 250 rpm. You check it. This is N2. N2 is 250 rpm. We can check it. Once you can check it, 750 into 150 divided by 450, that is 250 rpm. This is correct. So this rpm is 250 rpm. Now this, because both of them are on the same shaft, this will also rotate at 250 rpm. This will rotate at 250 rpm. So N3 is same as N2, so it is 250 rpm. Now this 3 drives pulley 4, pulley 3 drives pulley 4. So N4D4 will be equal to N3D3. Now I know N3, I know D3, I know D4, so I have to find out N4. So N4 will be equal to N3D3 divided by D4. So N3 is 250 into D3 is 900 divided by D4 is 150 mm. So this will be this is what you get. So 250 into 900 divided by 150, that gives me 1500 rpm. So this will be the speed of the pulley, driven pulley This is the speed of the driven pulley neglecting slip, if slip is not considered. If slip of 2% on each pulley is considered, on each pulley means here 2%, here 2%. This will not be, there will be no slip there because they are on both same this thing. Between that pulley and this pulley, there is a this thing of 4%. That is 2% each means totally it will be 4%. In that case, what happens is, I will take it like this. When slip is considered, considering slip. Now what I require is N2. N2 will be equal to N1 into D1 by D2. N2 into 100 minus S by 100. Now N1 is 750 into D1 is 150. This is 450 into 100 minus 4, 2 plus 2, 2% here, 2% there. So totally it will be 4%, 100 minus 4 by 100. That means this works out to 0.96. So now 750, I'll do this way. 0.96, this will be 0.96, 96 by 100 is 0.96 into 150 into 750 divided by 450. Now it will be 240. Earlier it was 250 RPM, now it is 240 RPM. It will be 240 RPM. This is the speed. There is a reduction of 10 revolutions per minute in the speed when we consider slip. So this is N2. Now N3 is same as N2, so this will also be 240 RPM. So what will be the speed of that? Again, there is a 4% this thing. I want N4. N4 will be equal to, again, N4 will be equal to N3 D3 divided by D4 into multiplied by 100 minus S divided by 100. So now N3 is 240 now. 240 into D3 is 250 divided by, no, sorry, D3 is 900. D3 is 900 divided by D4 is 150 mm, all in mm, into 100 minus 4 divided by 100 again. So there is a slip of 4% here. So 100 minus 4 this thing. So this will be 0.96 into 900 into 240 divided by 150. So now it will be 1382.4 RPM, or you can give it as 1382 RPM. So this is how it is, this problem is to be done. This is a problem on velocity ratio.